In this video, we're going to convert one of our previous projects into a class so that we can make multiple instances of it. I like the star project that we did back when we were doing variables and loops. So I'm going to open up processing. And I am going to hit this little down arrow to let me create a new tab, which is actually a new class, and the class name will be Star. And it should be capital S because classes should be named with a capital. It helps indicate that they are a class. And then, let's see if I could just grab my code here. No sense retyping something I've already got. So we've put that in here and we're going to convert it to a class. Now, when we're creating a class, we'll plan the class using a class diagram. And this is really easy to do. A class diagram is basically a table, and it's usually simply three cells. And the top cell is the name of the class. And the next cell is the variables the class will have. So we're going to just leave it in shades of gray, but we're going to have the variable of, our variables will be an int x, int y, int square, that's our size, and those are the variables that we could pass in. We actually are going to pass in one more. I'm going to do int color, and we're just going to do it in shades of gray, that we can pass in when we call this. And then we're going to have functions. And we can have multiple functions in here. We may not use them all at the same time. We can have display and we don't really need to pass anything into that. And we might also have move. So that's the basic, this is what's called a class diagram. Pretty easy way to plan a class. And so we need to make this match our class diagram. So I'm going to change the code around a bit and then I'll come back and explain what I did.